Welcome to Filmora Pro. My name is Johnny, and today we're going to be talking about the most recent update to Filmora Pro, version 1.4. This new update brings several new features, including support for DCI 4K, support for importing video with multiple audio tracks, but most importantly, this new update brings masking to Filmora Pro. This is a game-changing feature which makes Filmora Pro even more powerful than it was before. But before we get into what you can do with it, I want to show you how you can create masks in Filmora Pro. Let's take a look. So there are tons of parameters with masking in Filmora Pro, but I'll take you through the basics right now. If you look at the bottom left of the viewer panel, you'll see this new tool right here. This is the rectangle mask tool. When you select it, you can drag over a clip to create a new mask. This means everywhere outside of the shape you've just made will go transparent, allowing you to add things in the background. When you click and hold down on the rectangle mask tool, you will see a couple other mask options. You have the ellipse mask tool, which allows you to make oval and circular masks. And we also have the freehand mask tool, which can be used to make a mask of any shape and size, as well as edit the shape of any mask you've already created. Once you've created a mask, you have even more options in the controls panel. To find it, make sure your clip is selected, and then in the controls panel, look for your mask heading where you should find your mask. To the right of that, you can invert your mask if you want, and even change the blend modes for them. Under shape, you can expand your mask, feather the edges, and even add roundness. Under transform, you can keyframe your mask's path, which is extremely powerful, as well as change basic parameters like opacity, position, and scale. The possibilities are really limitless and make compositing in Filmora Pro so much more powerful. So with all that in mind, here are 5 cool things you can do with masks in Filmora Pro. I'm going to go over these pretty quickly, but if you really liked one of these examples and you want to learn more about it, let me know in the comments below. Number 1, easily create shapes. Creating shapes in Filmora Pro is easier than ever. Simply go to the media panel, click New, Plane, choose the color you'd like your shape to be, and drag the plane into your timeline. For a rectangular shape, select the Rectangle Mask tool. You can also create a square by holding Shift while you create your mask. If you want to make a circle, select the Ellipse Mask tool and hold Shift while dragging to create your mask. Finally, you can use the freehand mask tool to make any shape you want. You can even have multiple shapes interact with each other by creating several masks on the same plane and playing with their individual blend modes. For example, I've got these two masks on the same plane, but when I set our circle mask's blend mode to subtract, you'll see that the circle disappears. We can move it by using the selection tool. Then we can drag it over to where our square mask is, and we'll see it will actually cut out part of the square. So the amount of shapes you can make is practically endless. Number 2, refine green screen shots. If you have chroma or luma key shots, but that green screen just doesn't fill your image, or you've applied your green screen effect, but certain areas are proving really tricky to key out, you can use masks to get rid of those stubborn areas. You can even do rotoscoping by animating the mask path, which brings me to Number 3, reveal text behind objects. You can reveal big titles behind foreground objects, just like this. The way you can do this is by laying out your footage on the bottom track, putting your text on a track above, and then copying and pasting your background footage on the track above your text. Next, draw a mask around your foreground object with the freehand mask tool. Enable keyframing on the mask's path by clicking this circle, and adjust your mask every few frames if your foreground changes over time. Top that up with a bit of feathering and you've got yourself an awesome text reveal. Number 4, more powerful color grading. Filmora Pro lets you color grade with even more precision with masking. For example, let's say we want to apply a different color grading effect to our subject's face in the shot. We can do this by copying our clip, pasting it, and putting it on the track above. Next, we can use the ellipse tool to create a mask around her face. We can change the color adjustments to either the foreground or the background of the clip. In this case, I'll lower the brightness for the background, and then add some feathering to the mask to help it blend in more. This technique can also help with bringing down blown out areas in your shots, or raising darker areas of your shots. Number 5, clone yourself. Probably one of the most fun things you can do in Filmora Pro is clone yourself. Simply film yourself with a camera on a tripod and act out in different areas of the frame. Next, isolate the two parts of the clip where you're in the two different areas of your shot. Then, move one of the clips onto the track above the other. On the top of the clip, use one of the mask tools to create a mask around your subject. And then add some feathering to help it blend in. and now you've successfully cloned yourself. We'll be going more in depth on this effect in a future video, so stay tuned. So, are you excited for using masking in Filmora Pro? Let us know in the comments down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more video editing tips. And remember, there's no limit to what you can create.